When a parent goes to prison, they never go alone. Their family, their children go with them. In the state of Pennsylvania, I believe we have over 80,000 children who have had a parent incarcerated. That number grows if you include our local county jails and our federal prisons. Some children are paying close to a dollar or more a minute to talk to a parent, some even more. Across this country, our prison phone industry exploits inmates and their families, and companies compete for lucrative, long-term contracts with prisons that have exorbitant fees and rates and sometimes kickbacks to those state prisons. While the Federal Communications Commission has tried to place caps on these fees, those companies have sued, and as a result, the inmate calling services and that industry and all the reforms that were once in place are now in a state of flux. According to the Prison Phone Justice website, however, Pennsylvania is actually among the most affordable when it comes to the prison phone system. Our current phone service contract is actually much less than 1 cent per minute. But we can do more. We can do more to make sure that communication between an incarcerated parent and a child is as affordable and accessible as possible. It is definitely worth it. In my district, the Free Library of Philadelphia actually hosts a program called Stories Alive. It is a program hosted at the Widener Branch in North Philadelphia that allows inmates in our county prison to have story time with their children via Skype. For these children, having contact with their incarcerated parent has been found to have positive implications both in their emotional development and their education, and has secured attachments and relationships for a time to come. Research has consistently shown that contact with family members facilitates family reunification, eases an inmate's transition back into the community, and reduces recidivism rates. Family members provide social support and much more that can inhibit future criminal activity. Phone contact with loved ones is often viewed as especially vital to families when the inmate is incarcerated in a remote area that may take hours to visit, or when either the inmate or the child is unable to write letters due to spelling, grammar, or other writing skills. It also eases the stress of a caregiver who is trying their best to facilitate and maintain contact between both the parent and child. That's why I'm introducing legislation to require the Department of Corrections to provide incarcerated parents with a free phone call to their child at least once per month. This piece of legislation would ensure that incarcerated parents are able to speak with their children regularly, regardless of their financial means, and by providing them with this one free phone call per month to their child helps to maintain parent and child relationships. This will combat both risk faced by both the parent and the child, and ensure that the child will have a better success at both academic and other behavioral strides in their life. As we focus our attention on what is happening nationally, as we see children who are being separated from their parents at our country's border, we understand the importance of family reunification and family connection. In this Commonwealth, when it comes to the intersection of our criminal justice system and our child welfare system, in this space, we must also address this issue of family connection as well, to make sure that both parents and children have the tools that they need to maintain and cultivate healthy relationships and be successful.